Today, we will dive deeper into new modeling features of 3ds Max 2023. For the last 5 weeks, I've been playing around with the new version of the Max. My last video covered briefly all the new features. If you haven't watched it yet, I put the link in the corner or in the description below. Today, I will explain to you the new working pivot tools in more details, so let's get started. You can access working pivots in 3 different ways, using this toolbar. From the tool menu under Snap Working Pivot Tools. When you click here, you can create a floating menu. Or from Quads, right-click anywhere on the viewport. You can find it here. These points let you place the working pivot on any vertex, edge, face components or midpoint of these components on the active object in the scene. I will add an edit poly modifier to my geometry and select one polygon. Here we can choose between working pivot and view pivot. To create a new working pivot, all you have to do is to click this option and choose where to place your working pivot. You can choose the center of the polygon, vertex, or midpoint. When you click and hold, you can also choose the orientation of the pivot. Now you can move, scale, or rotate in the directions of the new pivot. I move the working pivot here. Next, let's scale it down while holding Shift to create an insert. Then, let's move it with Shift pressed to do a smart extrude. In the new version of Max, smart extrude option works in Edit Poly modifier. It used to work only in Editable Poly. Now, I want to extrude this polygon in this direction. I just have to set a new working pivot. Super easy! For example, we can also move vertices in the direction of the polygon. Now, let's say you want to extrude these two polygons in the direction of the first one. You don't have such an option with the extrude tool. But with this new tool, you can just place the working pivot here and smart extrude it. Then, we can move this vertex to the same plane. With the working pivot, it moves in the right direction. Let me do some more operations to show you how it works. Next, let me show you more tools from the Working Pivots toolbar. Let's start with the Selection Pivot. With this option, Working Pivot is aligned the position and orientation to the average of the current vertex, edge, or face selection. You can access it with Alt plus Shift plus S shortcut for quick and easy use. Do you like it so far? Let me know in the comments. I will create a new working pivot to show you the align option. Just click this icon and you can align your pivot at any time. You can also reset the working pivot with this icon. Another cool thing is the ability to choose pivot from bounding box. I will create a sphere to explain it to you. Here, you can turn this option. Now, when I choose a working pivot, I can see the object's bounding box. I will pick this point. I will move it to the center of the grid so you can see it better. Let's pick the point again. I will use the scale tool. Here, we can choose the working pivot. This way, we can scale the sphere so it stays within the grid lines at all times. It can be handy sometimes. Let's cover the next tool. Here, I have a simple ramp model. You can see that one polygon is not straight. We can place a working pivot there and then use this icon to create a grid from it. As a result, we have a new grid at the same angle as the polygon. We can use it to create new objects on it. We can draw shapes as well. We can move it around and it will stay on the grid. It will be very useful while working on exterior visualizations with more complex terrain. In the next example, I will show you how to use points. Here, I have collapsed the spotlight model. Let me detach each element. The problem is that all the pivots are in one place. We can fix it quickly. Let's place the working pivot here. Now we just have to click this button and the pivot is aligned to this point. Here it is. Let's do the same with the other objects. After we place the working pivot, we can click here to add the point in the place of the working pivot. We can link the model to this point, and as a result, we can control this object with the point. We need to use a local pivot. We can quickly control the rotation of that part. You can create other points and link everything together to create this effect. Pretty cool, right? If you want to learn how to create amazing architectural visualizations and animations in 3ds Max, I'd like to invite you to join our online courses. Click here to check them out on our website. Bye bye!